This news article is kind of strange. The question is, who is Pedro Peter?
Hunter Biden's iPhone XS has been hacked. Evidently, Joe Biden has used a name of Peter Henderson. So, pedo means pedophile. So he's saying, or he's hinting, that his dad too is a pedophile.
If you have a piece of crack cocaine no bigger than this quarter that I'm holding in my hand, $0.0025, we passed a law through the leadership of Senator Thurman and myself and others, a law that says you're caught with that, you go to jail for 5 years. You're caught with that, you go to jail.
This is a difficult scenario.
The Wild Wild West.
Yeah, we need to have talks about the professionalism in this environment.
What's going on with the guys?
It's insane, man. The guys have run absolutely amok.
You too. Dude, I remember you used to show up and be like, hey, thank you for having me. This is an exciting opportunity.
This is a business environment, dude. You can't just
go as much as you think it's all fun, dude.
Yeah, this is we're a very serious business enterprise.
We're an LLC.
Yeah.
We're a corporation.
S-type. The S-type.
Yes.
The S-types. And you're just going to fart before production.
And you're farting.
You farted audibly before production.
Shawn Gardini, dude. Shawn Gardini.
It's a legend.
The superstar.
You taunted us.
Fartini.
Shane, come on.
Shawn, do you have any insight into who Pedo Pete really is?
I mean, I've heard that it could be the president of the United States.
Yeah, you don't have anything backing that up. Now you're throwing accusations at the president.
It's a legend.
Of being a pedophile.
Wait, is Pedo Pete coming from the Hunter Biden shit?
Yeah. Dude. That's his contact name in the phone.
There's a thing that says Pedo Pete and mom, allegedly, in the phone.
It's the family GC.
And apparently they're saying Peter something was the name. Again, it's all speculative, but they're saying there was a alias Biden used for like government work that was named after a Thomas Clancy spy character named Pete or something. Pete Henderson.
How about, did you see the Washington Post run a Crack's Not Bad article?
What?
For real. It's fucking, maybe I'm getting fake news on that. Allegedly, I saw it on Twitter, so who knows if it's real.
Yeah.
But the Washington Post, like this, 2 days ago, ran a article that was like, is crack really that bad? It turns out a little bit of crack's not that bad, and conservatives vilified it because they're racist.
What?
Yeah. It's like, damn, come on, bro.
They're saying Hunter's just super open-minded.
They're just like, Hunter's pretty cool.
Yeah, well, yeah. There's also from the things,
doing?
Again, this
what
is...
What the hell's going on?
It's very, you know...
We are live from my parents' basement.
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, yeah. I've already completed, like, 2 loops on that thing. It's pretty nasty. You really got to
rip it. My nephew's going to be pissed. He's going to be like the Three Bears. He's going to come home and say, somebody's been using my track. Something ain't right. Somebody's been using my Hot Wheels track.
He might actually notice.
I never liked Hot Wheels tracks.
Really?
I liked the look of them.
Yeah.
I thought they were sick. I could never get it going.
I like the ones where you had a little remote. Did you ever get those where you had the little thing and you're fucking...
Yeah, you control how fast it goes.
You get greedy around the curve.
I launched it off every curve. Yeah. I never once... pulled my foot off the gas, dude.
Nah,
I could never stop. I'd just be like, all right, here we go. Just fly off every time.
I know. Yeah, you can. It was tough. It was tough not to fully launch it. But yeah, dude, they're saying, they're also saying he searched like 12 year old, like child.
I saw
porn.
That.
That was like.
Is it Pornhub search? It was like Pornhub. 12 year old.
Yeah. And, you know, people are, it's funny too. And like, you know, he illegally registered a firearm. It's like, all right.
That's the least of our worries.
Yeah, that's, yeah. Well, there's 2 camps. Some people are like, who cares about the crack? You got to worry about, like, the things he did against, I don't even know about that, but they're saying, like, there's, like, real things. And then other people are like, fuck that.
Well,
it's crack and
again,
sex
I've done no research.
Crazy.
But wasn't he on the board for, like, companies in Ukraine?
I think so, yeah. I think so.
Why?
Glenn Beck.
How?
Glenn was his dad's a fucking president.
No, of course, but I mean, the dude doing crack with his dick out constantly.
Yeah.
It was on a board.
Yeah, dude.
They're like, we have a Zoom meeting today with the chairman.
Dude, I genuinely think that's like a large, you know, there's like a lack of money and excesses of money, both corrupt. So if you have no money, it has a degenerative effect. Sorry to say that, it just does. And then if you have too much money, it kind of has a degenerative effect.
Yeah.
See the video of the little kids in their underwear, like hitting ATF agents?
I did see that.
Dude, how crazy was that?
I didn't get to watch it. I saw the caption, so I figured it was them saying like,
fuck you,
bitch
pussy,
ass.
Bitch ass.
Like, punching cops.
It's just
in diapers.
It's like it's a bunch of like 3-year-olds in Batman underwear. It's like, fuck you, pussy. And it's punching ATF, like just like fucking launching punches on ATF agents. And there's like, dude, the argument under that's, yeah, dude, I think social media has proved to be a negative thing. It'll be cigarettes, dude. I'm telling you, in 20 years, it's going to be like, you're going to be having a phone out around a kid and someone's going to be like, yo, buddy, can you go outside?
Yeah.
Like, don't open that shit up around my kid.
Yeah, if you're going to look at bikini pictures of a girl you knew in high school, why don't you take that outside?
They're going to make you step outside.
You're going like this, zooming in so you can get a better look at her body.
Oh. Just that little fold, like, just that fold in the bikini. Yeah, I can definitely. You can confirm,
like,
you confirm lips. Have you ever confirmed lips in a bikini pic? Lips confirmed. Confirmed.
we have lips.
That's the gateway to crack, dude.
What, lips? High school girl.
Confirming lips.
A girl you knew from high school's lips.
Confirming clips.
Now that she's got children, the lips are. She's down at Ocean City, Maryland. Lips out. Sun's out.
The lips are like some sort of like carving on the Little Mermaid castle now. They're just like an ornamental shell. It's fully rippled. Yeah. Yeah, dude. It's a funny thing, especially while I'm reading the Lafayette book, the one you gave me, the Marquis de Lafayette, looking at like the courtesans of Versailles and then seeing the stuff with Hunter Biden. It's the same thing.
How about they used to fucking diss our boy Marquis just because he wouldn't fuck other chicks?
Because
he loved his babe.
Yeah.
Everybody in the royal court was like, this guy sucks.
Yeah, you were supposed to have
a
side piece.
He's not doing our orgies and having side pieces in our freak mansion.
Yep.
The more you read about Versailles, the happier I am. The boys got in there and chopped everyone's heads off.
Well, then you start saying, like,
but then they took it too far.
Like, the guy with his dick out and, like, having sex with prostitutes is running things. It's like, well, yeah, reading a book about pre-revolutionary France. Yeah, I can believe that.
You think we're pre-revolutionary France right now in the Estados Unidos?
Maybe. It's just good times make weak men. We're good times made weak men, and weak men are making bad times right now. Dude, Hunter Biden should be worried about his country. His daddy's the president.
I don't know. You got to be careful with that saying.
Why?
A lot of people aren't sure if that's right. Everybody likes to say hard times make good men, and, you know, good times make soft men.
Mm-hmm.
Hard times make fucked up evil people.
True. Sometimes they
do. Hard times, like World War I, you get some Hitlers.
True.
You know?
True.
And you get World War II, which, you know, we like the movies, but boy, that was the worst thing of all time.
Pretty bad.
It was literally the worst thing that ever happened to the earth.
But then after that, what happened? People pulled
Japan
their pants up.
Japan started making fucking VCRs.
That's what I'm saying.
We started telling everyone what to do.
We pulled our pants up. Everyone, the world after that, we had a 50-year period where everyone pulled their pants up. Japan started making VCRs.
I knew he couldn't resist. I knew he couldn't resist. He heard the chatter start.
What a proper goodbye.
You're out of here? You need 8 to 10 tickets.
On Thursday night.
Okay.
Believe me, there's seats all over the place.
Sold out. It's sold. Pittsburgh Improv sold out, baby.
The cars are facing the wrong.
I told you guys.
No, they won't.
They did.
When?
They ticketed your car. $20.
We parked. I saw him park the other way, so I parked the other way, and I said, Phil's gonna come out and he's gonna say, guys, just so you know, your car's facing the opposite direction. They're gonna ticket
Cops?
You. I've seen them ticket you.
I'd love to see him touch my car.
If those fucking dumb pigs come out, I'm gonna push them. Phil, this house, we believe in science.
True. If I see blue lives around my car,
Phil,
I'm gonna fucking go off.
Fuck the blue lives. Trump's a pussy. Phil.
They put the rumble strips.
Phil. Trump's a pussy.
Oh, bullshit.
Yeah, bullshit.
Oh.
Told you.
Oh,
both
that's
things.
So good.
How well do I know that man?
That's so good.
As soon as the red light comes on, he's got to be around the camera.
Oh, yeah.
He's a little gory hound, dude. And I also, yeah, he was going to tell us, you get ticketed for parking
against
the opposite direction.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
But yeah, hard times might make fucking insane people.
True.
So,
this is true.
You know?
It's the Kali Yuga.
If you get hit with some trauma as a young man, you might end up a little dinged up and you might end up.
Well, what I think happens though, then.
Starving a country.
Then I think, yeah, true. But then once you fully starve the country, you have enough people who like completely dissociate from real life and then they just sit in their head and make good ideas all day. And then they make a lot of good ideas.
There is that side. I think people suck no matter what.
The internet, dude. The internet was born.
Yes. I watched hypernormalization this week, so I'm tapped into, you know, cyberspace.
Really?
Yeah, all the artists and the counterculturalists had to escape, dude. The politicians weren't going to help. We had to escape into cyberspace.
Yeah.
Which is where we are right now.
Yeah, I think they found us in cyberspace, and now that's launched into a fully commercialized enterprise that I think is having a negative effect on the entire world.
All that matters is my nephew has this.
True.
That rules. This is real.
This thing doesn't have
fucking social media.
Nah.
He has that.
I mean, you could do that all day. You could do that all day.
That's better.
But yeah, that is funny. It's funny to watch people argue over those tapes and being like, fuck this. I saw the same thing, being like, okay, so he's smoking a little bit of crack.
Yeah.
Whatever. It's like, I agree. It's whatever, but you know. It's clearly though, I think it points to the fact that we may be being run by highly incapable people with very dark personal lives that have the power to scrub them through the media and suppress people. And, you know, maybe that'll lead to something bad. I don't know. We'll see.
I think it's going to lead to something fucking catastrophic. I think it's going to lead to something real catastrophic.
So do I.
But I hope not. I hope we're just gay. You know? You know how every podcaster is like, the end of the world's coming. We're all fucked.
I don't. This is bad.
I hope.
I don't think it's the end of the world. I think it's the end of our eternal comfort. That's what COVID was. It was like, you know, geezers obviously died, sucks, and other people died, sucks, but like, in terms of the stuff other parts of the world deal with, it was probably if that had hit Africa,
that
would have been another day, that would have been a day in the life.
Yeah.
Hitting like a fucked up part of Africa.
Like, there's a cold going around. It's like, yeah, well, there's hippos that eat us when we get water.
Yeah.
So that's a problem.
Yeah.
But you know, that's not all of Africa, obviously.
No, obviously
that's a gross
not.
Generalization. There's obviously very advanced cities.
But I'm sure there would be parts of it though that would have hit. It would have hit and they'd have been like, yeah, more people. That would have been like the ticker on the news. Be like, slightly more people than usual died today.
Yeah.
We'll
Let's go back to Marquis, dude. What do you think of Marquis that Lafayette?
I like him.
What do you like about him?
I just like him, dude.
He just loves liberty.
He loves liberté. And the fact that he was being laughed. He wouldn't have a side piece. When he just started being silent.
Those charlatans, dude.
Big
those
time.
Fucking
courtesans, dude. Those
disgusting Parisians at Versailles just laying around like.
Disgusting.
You're not sucking and fucking everyone.
Yeah. You need a side piece.
So then he goes to America.
Well, dude,
he says, I'm here to fight for freedom, dude.
Yeah, fuck this.
I'll give you guys a bunch of money. Let me fight.
When he did the vow of silence. I mean, he was like, everything I say sucks. And he's like, I'll be silent and people think I'm deep as hell. And everyone's like, dude, this guy's so weird. Why won't he talk to anyone?
It was a good move.
That was a sick move.
Everyone ended up thinking he's smart. So how far have you gotten? Have you gotten through?
They're building up the French Revolution right now.
Yeah, it's a real bummer when that shit goes on.
Well, I just stopped the part where the king invited, like the king tried to reason with everybody and use them as pawns. It didn't work.
Yeah.
So the king invited him to the pillow bed or something. Where it's like everyone lays on pillows, and the king laid everyone down on a balmy, like a summer afternoon, and was like, here's the deal. You guys are going to do what the fuck I tell you to do. And they were like all pissed, then he fell asleep in the pillows. Dude, imagine laying down a bunch of people and be like, look, here, I know,
guys,
you know, you're pretty
don't
wealthy.
Don't worry, I got this completely under control. I know shit seems like it sucks right now.
Dude, passed out. Imagine laying on pillows and having somebody infuriate you, and you have to just lay there and be like, motherfucking bitch, dude. Fuck this guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, here's the deal. I know you guys, I assembled you guys, you know, to hear your ideas or whatever, but it turns out I'm not going to use any of them, and you're going to do exactly what I say.
I feel bad for that king.
Yeah.
I usually don't support monarchies, but he was trying, dude. He was just trying to maintain the lineage. Everyone kept being like, no more kings, dude. We're done with kings. And he was like, I can't be the guy who fucking ruins it.
I know.
I gotta try to pretend to be tough.
Yeah, but dude, I mean, he funded a war of independence. So that was tough, man. sounded cool. The level to which all those dudes want glory is so fucking funny.
Yeah.
When they're like, and they just write about it. Dude, the letters back then are my favorite thing. It's like when George, he thinks he's not going to see George Washington again. He's like, it deflates my soul, my general.
Yes.
It's like, dude, what? The broship never has been
strong. The broship was strong. Especially because you could say one thing to a guy every 6 months.
True.
So you had to write down like the sickest shit ever.
It was, you basically sent your boy bars, basically.
You did. You had to write like poetically.
Yeah.
And like, if you said something, I mean, if you were just like, dude, you're the man, I miss you. Yeah. See you later. He'd be like,
oh, no.
The disrespect.
It was crazy, dude.
The disrespect.
It's when dudes could just talk slavery. Just be like, dude, just I don't know, slaves. Man. I don't know. It might be fucked up. Washington be like, yeah, it's pretty fucked
up. It's definitely fucked up. But, I know what I've been doing.
Yeah, he's like, but, you know, we'll figure it out later.
The Marquis, they'd all
yeah, he was it. Sick, dude. He got kicked out of, or not, he escaped France. Dude. They tried to detain him.
Yeah.
They tried to fucking detain him and be like, nah, dude, they were gonna just bury him. He would have been a laughingstock.
Yeah. So the all right, so you got to the revolution part.
Oh, I read the Revolutionary War part. So they tried to just like bury him and take him out in the country, and then he was like, fuck off, hopped on a boat, took off.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm at the, when they're building up to it.
They try to get him in France again. When he comes back during the revolution.
When he's too much
behind. He's kind of a hero during that, then they're kind of like, they just lose control of the revolution.
I didn't know the French, I knew the French like helped the Revolutionary War. I didn't know they won it, like they completely won the war.
Yeah.
Like, dude, we were fucked.
Yeah.
Washington didn't win at all. I mean,
he was a great retreat.
He knew how to retreat, and that's the thing.
Come on, man,
dude. That I know, but this is the thing, and you know, from a military, I'm more like the young Marquis de Lafayette. I'm like, yeah. Go attack him, glory. But that one dude, the French general, that was like, dude, do not sacrifice your men's lives for glory. That part of the letter,
that was sick.
That was great.
Yeah,
when he was like, dude, we should let's.
When he
would
got
just,
scolded by the big dogs, they were like, shut up,
dude. It was so funny. Him just being like, come on, guys, you guys are fucking pussies. Let's go attack them. He was like, my whole ship of people are sick. He's like, fuck that. Let's go. I was like, dude, you'll get 10,000 dudes killed.
Yeah,
shut the fuck up.
Yeah,
that's nuts, dude. To think about those dudes who would be like, give me a troop. Come on, give me troops.
Yeah,
and being like, it's my time. Let's ride.
And it's time for me to become a hero, and then and you having get slaughtered by Indians out in the woods. You get your fucking dicks chopped off, put in your mouth. Anyway,
but yeah, that was great.
Here's what, dude. You want, now we're talking history. Don't get me started.
PH.
I was watching fucking that Netflix Pearl Harbor doc. Got me fucking going, dude.
Really?
I get so pissed when I think about what the fucking Japanese did to us on Pearl Harbor. Dude.
Do you really?
Yeah, well, in the fucking, it must be because it's British. They interview Japanese survivors of Pearl Harbor, like the pilots.
What?
Yeah, I'm sitting there.
Kamikaze survived?
They didn't use kamikazes yet. They weren't getting
They bombed.
They weren't getting whipped yet.
So they just bombed?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought they kamikaze.
No, there were no kamikazes at Pearl Harbor, but.
My mistake.
They did kind of, they had like these things called midget subs. They were essentially suicide missions. They just sent two dudes in like tiny little subs.
To do what?
Fucking, I don't know.
Into like,
I don't know what the fuck
what
they were doing.
Did they crash into like boardwalk piers?
Yeah, I have no idea what they were doing. The midget subs were trying to fire like one torpedo, and then two dudes would just be stuck in this thing.
What?
Yeah, we blew one up, which is pretty funny.
That's good.
Like early, before Pearl Harbor started, they found a midget sub like in the harbor, and this ship was just like, what the fuck's that?
And they
blow
Japanese
it up. It's just two Japanese dudes. They got hit with like a depth charge.
Oh my God.
It's like a 10-foot long fucking boat.
What?
Midget sub. Yeah, it's like a little tiny thing, but they got hit with a depth charge. They must have got eviscerated.
Yeah, dude.
They got hit with a bomb that was the size of their boat.
I mean, blowing up underwater is probably kind of cool, though.
It probably hurts so bad. It's probably just pressure.
Yeah, but explosion, too. So you blow up and then explode, but water rushes in?
I think they're just knocked. You're just fucked.
You think you're gone?
You're knocked out immediately.
True.
If a depth charge hits your fucking tiny sub...
Yeah.
Just you and another dude, like, oh shit, they're on to us.
You don't think they're getting like, it's hot, it's cold.
True.
Oh, I'm all fucking wet.
Fire
now.
And
shit.
Water.
Yeah, that's pretty nuts.
But no, they were interviewing fucking pilots. The guy was like, I hit the wrong ship. I wish I'd hit the Utah. That still bothers me. It's like,
it?
You piece of shit.
Oh,
it was
really?
A sneak attack. Yeah.
Oh, they're still talking shit?
That guy was still kind of talking shit. It's
what?
Like, bro, you know what happens. Stop talking shit.
Yeah.
You must have forgot, dude.
Did they?
Don't make us come back over there.
don't make
us come back over there.
Someone's going to drop. You think someone's going to drop another nuke?
Someday.
We're not going to get the only one. Although.
It'd be sick if we did. If we got the only two and we're like, nobody else is allowed
it'd be
to do that.
Yeah, it would be preferred.
That's
be like,
big
look,
brother attitude.
Look,
dude.
We did it. Trust me, you guys don't want to do a nuke.
Yeah.
It took out, it literally devastated our enemy.
It made
us
feel sad.
It devastated our enemy so quick and brought a swift end to the, like, trust me, you guys
don't.
Yeah,
you guys definitely don't want to
do this.
Then
we were rich as fuck for like 140 years, pretty much now forever. Trust me, you guys don't want this.
It really is like Dewey Cox. Where he's like, what's that? It's like, it's a nuclear weapon. He's like, nah, I don't want to do that. You don't want any part of this shit.
Nah, you don't want that.
It ends the war immediately.
Every single American has to live with that on their conscience, dude. And it, every day I wake up, I go, God fucking damn it.
Dude, I had to watch it. I watched that. All right. My mom's coming down. Mom, don't say, what do you need? Yeah, we're on right now. Oh. You're making meatball subs for the guys? Yes, that's very exciting news. Thank you, Mom. I love you.
Thank you.
You probably had a feeling we were on based on the camera and the microphones. God damn it. They never come say hi to me ever. Second the camera's on, dude.
Your pa wanted a proper goodbye, I could tell.
Paul wanted to
see. He's hitting the road. He was like, boy.
I'm going to see him this weekend.
Write him a letter.
He's asking for 10 tickets.
Yeah, write him a letter.
He's bringing his bros to the Pittsburgh show.
Oh, that's going to be nice.
It's going to be all right.
That'll be fun.
They're all the same. It's It's 10 bald dudes in polos tucked into khaki shorts with cell phone clips.
Strong men.
Those are strong men.
They're strong men.
I like what you said about Biden up there. That part was pretty funny.
Oh, yeah.
Shane, hey, Phil, this guy's pretty funny. Your son's pretty funny.
Yeah, they're strong men for sure.
But no, I didn't like interviewing Japanese pilots from Pearl Harbor.
Yeah. That's crazy.
For real, it's like interviewing dudes from 9/11.
Yeah, wouldn't we?
Be like, here's the cowards that did the fucking bullshit sneak attack on us.
Yeah.
But I had to cleanse my palate. I had to watch some Walter Filipek again.
What was that?
Remember that old dude from World War II that was in the Pacific? It's just a face-to-face interview.
Oh, yeah.
Just a dude who doesn't care about what he did.
That'd be nice to have a sit-down between those guys.
He literally is talking. Walter Filipek, oh, my God. Filipek would shoot him. Dude,
he
kill
would get him?
Every story Walter tells is him threatening to shoot a guy, even on his own side. It'll be like a sergeant would be like, you go do that. He'd be like, I'll shoot you right now. I'll fucking kill you. They were like, all right, dude.
Well, dude, I didn't realize they did that in the... In that one, in the Marquee book, the soldiers were in like better conditions and they would just like shoot their sergeant.
Yeah, oh,
they would just murder their sergeant.
Well,
like,
there was
what the fuck?
They'd be out in a fucking fort.
Yeah.
In the woods.
And you're killing people.
Yeah.
That's your job. You're killing people. So it's like, all right, this seems to be pretty effective for them.
It's a good way to change people's minds if I kill them.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. And then they finally hung. They're like, they gave the one guys like weekends off. They killed their sergeant. Like, all right. And then Washington came down. He goes, what the fuck?
Kill everybody.
Hung the whole platoon. Yeah, you've hung them.
Washington had no problem shutting down mutinies.
I didn't realize how much he used murder too. Like back then, you had to like, all right, we're gonna kill like 140 dudes. Yeah. We can't have this.
Hold on, I gotta get one more Walter.
True.
He was going through and he was talking about. I'm sure I've said it 1,000 times, but he's talking about how some of the Japanese would have grenades, the wounded.
Mm-hmm.
So like you'd go over to check on them and they'd take out. Because we would send medics to try to help. So Walter would just go around and shoot everybody that was wounded. He would just execute. He was executing prisoners and shit. And he was like, he looks at the camera. He's like, yeah, it's cruel, but I done it. He keeps going like, yeah, I fucking did it. It's the best. It's so good. Just him. The Japanese picture. Yo, chill. His words. He's like, his sergeant told him, he was like, Walter, take that prisoner out, bring him back to the back lines, be back in 1 minute. And he's like, oh, I know what that means. Go execute a prisoner. So he goes out with this Japanese dude, and he's like, give me that picture in your hand. And the guy's like, no. And he's like, so I shot him, and I took the picture.
I didn't see that one.
So fucking funny, dude. He holds it up, and he's like, here's the picture I got from that Jap. Now this here is them cutting off heads. Yeah, I don't know if they... He's like, I don't know if it's true, but that's what I was told. They're chopping off heads.
I mean, dude, imagine you're just a farm boy from back then.
He was from West, by God, Virginia. Someone goes, you're from West Virginia? He goes, West, by God, Virginia. And then they're like, were you scared? He's like, no, I didn't have a girlfriend. I didn't care if I died. I still don't care. Yeah. It's the best. It's the best. Made me so happy after watching that fucking Pearl Harbor.
Yeah.
Japanese pilot.
Saw the enemy.
I saw the enemy fucking laughing, dude. He was laughing about what happened.
Although, you know, that's what the gentleman used to do.
Dude, the Oklahoma way.
And once the war
was
over, you hung out.
The Oklahoma way? The USS Oklahoma flipped upside down. All the boys were trapped inside in the harbor. Yeah.
Trapped in the ship?
Yeah, in Pearl Harbor. Yeah, it was a bummer.
They didn't swim out?
Here's what I wanted to talk about. I know we're still, we got to go back to Lafayette.
No, go ahead.
Dude, his name was Doris Miller, bro.
Yeah.
So you know in Pearl Harbor when they have Cuba Gooding Jr.? Do you remember that movie?
Not really.
He's a cook on the ship.
Okay.
Black dude.
Yeah.
Because they had segregated back then.
Yeah, yeah.
So like the most you could do as a black dude in World War II for the most part was like fold shit in the Navy.
And they this let guy, them, they fight?
Dude, he was, Doris Miller was like the boxing champ on the boat. He's jacked.
What?
Wait till you see a picture of this
he
dude.
Was he's folding
like,
shit?
He looks like a fucking NFL linebacker today. He's like.
What the fuck?
When Pearl Harbor, when it popped off, he went, he was running around trying to help people. He went up to the captain of the ship who got wounded. He carried him out, saved him. Well, I don't know if he saved him, but he took him out.
Yeah, yeah.
And then he got his hands on a fucking anti-aircraft gun, which he never fired in his life.
What?
And just started taking out pilots.
What the fuck?
Yeah, dude. He's the man. Doris Miller.
Did he get hero recognition?
He did get hero recognition.
That's what's up.
They named a fucking boat after him. They got another one coming out.
Damn.
He died like 3 years later in the war.
Did he really?
Yeah, on a different ship. Still. Beast.
Fuck, that rules.
Yeah,
that
Doris was back. Miller.
Yeah.
True baller.
Dudes were like, I need to die. That's a sick... I mean, I'm not saying this was Doris Miller's life plan, but the dudes who were like, my destiny is to die on a battlefield.
Yeah.
Kind of rules.
Dude, just think of during Pearl Harbor, him just being like, fuck this.
I'm shooting this.
Getting on a fucking... You've never fired an anti-aircraft gun.
I couldn't imagine.
He just strapped himself in and was like... just fucking planes up. Just like, yo, I'm so good at this.
I mean,
this.
Dude, would anything be fun after that?
No.
Imagine how fun that would be to like literally shoot planes out of the sky.
Especially when all the honkies were like, you can't handle these guns.
Yeah, and just true. Be like, just flipping that last egg over, just flipping that egg over easy and being like, it's time.
Yeah, it's time for me to go, dude.
Hit the anti-
you hear the sirens, you're like, enough of this cooking bullshit.
Take your apron down, fold
one
it.
One more, Tojo. He was the admiral. He was basically the head honcho in Japan. Pretty funny story. I never looked up what happened to him. When the United States occupied Japan, they went to arrest all those leaders. Mm-hmm. He tried to kill himself. He tried to shoot himself in the heart, and he missed.
They'll do that.
Yeah, they,
you got to get them quick.
You got to get the Japanese quick. They're going for the button. He tried to shoot himself in the heart. He missed. He was like laying there, and his quote's like, everything we did was justified. Fuck you pussies. And then he lived, and they were like, you're going to jail. The United States resuscitated him just to hang him.
Did they really?
Yeah.
They dishonored him.
He was in jail for a while, and he got new teeth. Damn, Tybalt's coming down the whole gang.
Nice.
Nice. Who gives a fuck? Yo. He had to get new teeth, dentures, while he was in prison. And the American dentist who gave it to him carved Remember Pearl Harbor into the back of his fucking teeth.
So he could lick it and feel it?
Yeah.
Oh.
But it was in Morse code.
He probably knew Morse code. If he was an admiral of the Navy, he probably was pretty versed in Morse code. That sucks. Get to lick the Morse code.
Yeah, I'd be all right.
Dude, if my enemies engraved
fuck,
Morse code in my
so
teeth.
Pissed.
Imagine the first time you're going, huh?
Be like, oh yeah, fuck, I did that. Like, these guys are pissed.
I got busted, dude.
I'm going to get fucking hung for this.
I feel like that's a level of trouble that's so much trouble. It just kind of, people are like, eh, we got you. People aren't even pissed at that point.
Yeah.
Just kind of like, yeah, we got you, you motherfucker.
Yeah, you're the worst. You're one of the worst dudes ever.
You got
you're
us.
You're in trouble. You're bad.
That's so funny. The dentist got him like that.
The dentist. What a G, dude. There's so many stories in World War II that are fucking just Walters, dude. I love thinking of an army of fucking Walters. Like the Japanese and the Germans had no idea that America was populated with dudes from coal mines in West Virginia that were like, yeah, I shot the prisoners. I done it.
Yeah, it was just dudes.
It was cruel, but I done it.
They just took orders their whole lives.
Yeah.
They're like, go pick those weeds, boy. And they go out there and pick the weeds. And like, you're going to go fight those Japanese.
He's
you're
like, all right.
All right.
He's like, yeah, it rained for a month. I didn't like it. What could I do? So I shot him. It's like, nice, dude.
That's so, dude, those dudes were so fucking strong, too.
Yeah.
Just like 1940s farm boys?
Yeah.
They're the strongest.
Dude, literally a guy from a coal. His dad was in World War One. Came back and worked in a coal mine for 50 years. Then he was like, I want to be like my dad. And he just went to the coal mine, started working. And they pulled him out when he was 18 to go in World War II.
Imagine being a Japanese 19-year-old getting strangled to death by one of those guys. Just having the coal miner's hands around your neck. Like, yeah, you better hold still there.
Yep. Come here now.
Come on now.
Now you're shooting at my buddies, so now so, you're dead.
Fair's fair. Fair's fair. It is what it is.
Yeah, man.
No harm, no foul. Gone back.
Yeah,
gonna win
do yourself a favor. Walter Filipek.
Yeah, that is funny.
It's a YouTube video. It's an hour and a half of just a dude sitting there telling you stories about World War II, and he's like, totally. Tybalt, get away from the camera.
I mean, could you imagine the glory of that dude in like a VFW, ponying up? Just, what do you think he drinks, like Coors Banquet?
Who knows?
Sipping on a Coors Banquet.
God, this guy is so fucking dirty. He's a dirty ass.
He does have, like, when animals get old, they get their assholes just become
trash.
Tybalt
was born with a fucked up ass and a, really? Stub, and a stubby tail.
Old dogs have like porn star assholes. They ever see them? Every time you see an old like husky, it's the most
butts ruined.
Crazy. But yeah, that is fun. It's fun to think about that. Just dudes with like, just two groups of dudes with very minimal original thoughts in their head just strangling each other.
Yeah.
Just because they have to.
Yeah.
Literally
coal
had
miner
to do
and
it.
A dude from Japan meeting in a fucking volcanic island.
Just.
And people are like, go.
Just stop.
Like, all right. Okay.
Just stomping each other in the head and shooting each other.
He was telling stories about throwing grenades back and forth. He's like, now the Jap threw a grenade. I said, one, two. I threw it back at him. He threw it. Like, just two dudes throwing bombs at each other. Oh, man.
Just playing hot potato.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
With almost no fear of death on either side.
Yeah, true.
A bunch of Walters who were not afraid.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. There was a bunch of dudes out there that obviously feared death.
Yeah.
They were humans. But there were Walters.
Yeah. Definitely more so than today. There's no internet to read about, like, you know why we really went over there?
There's no Walters.
Like, these are bad guys.
There's almost no Walters left.
Nah. They need them. The military needs Walters more than ever.
We're going to need them. Because I think China might still have some Walters kicking around.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But I feel like, you know.
I thought Russia had some Walters. Turns out Ukraine does.
Really?
I think Ukraine's fucking hanging in there.
There's not a second. I haven't worried for a second that Ukraine's going to actually lose the war. I genuinely don't believe they will.
Nice.
I don't know why. I just have. I'm like, yeah, right. They're not going to lose. I just yeah, don't right. think. I don't even think. I'm like, yeah, sure. We'll see. They're like, oh, they took another city.
Yeah.
And you're like,
yeah.
Okay. We'll see. I mean, that sucks. But yeah, I have a feeling they're not going to completely lose because they have like the entire world power backing them. Although Putin's been throwing it out there, dude.
Putin's
basically
fired
being
up.
Like, they don't, like, dude, I'd love to see Western countries come try to fuck. It's like, dude, yeah. What are you talking about?
Dude, I watched the Frontline, the PBS. You ever watch those?
I've seen them before.
They're
all right,
I've
seen them before.
There's one on Putin right now that's just like, some the experts on it are fucking crazy.
What are they saying?
They're just like totally being like, and now Putin's scared, and you can tell. And it's like, dude, what are you talking about? It's some lady that worked for like the Atlantic for 1 year. That's her credit. It's like from 18 to 19, she worked at the Atlantic.
Okay, yeah.
She's like just saying crazy shit.
He's scared now?
I don't know. And then they're like, and then Trump took office, and it was the most embarrassing thing of all time. And that's when Russia got really powerful. It's like, why do you keep saying that?
What the fuck are you talking about?
He took Crimea under Obama.
Yeah.
And he invaded Ukraine under Biden. What's the...
Yeah, the red line. Wasn't that the red line?
For a Russian spy, you would think Trump would have helped him take Ukraine.
Yeah, I'm telling you. It's just...
Anyway.
These are the elites just...
Dude,
just
I'm back
completely
in Kingsburg. It's back. It's full Trump. Look at that. Nice try, Penn State. Stuffed. That's called Irish Impact. That's the name of that.
It was funny from the Lafayette book when the guy came out and was like, no, for real, here's the deal with the budget. This is what's going on. And then like he was kind of right. Then he used the newspaper to like, because he's like, I got to get this out. And like was mostly right about something. They were like, fuck you, dude. We were right. And they were like kind of wrong. I think that's pretty much, that's all that's happening. Just people being like, we're right. And everyone's just, you know. But, you know. Get on the track, baby. Get on the track. Damn. Here we go. You got a friend of me.
Tips,
you got a friend
dude.
Of me, Tybalt. Here you go.
That's good, Tybalt.
You got a friend of me, Tybalt. Yeah, dude, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, the funny part is you have all these guys like at the very top, and it's really is just a bottomless pit of like other dudes bubbling up to take the spot. There's so many people like, these guys are fucked up. We got to drain the swamp. It's like, dude, give it 5 years. The swamp will refill itself because, well, there's a lot of swamp creatures buzzing around.
There's a lot of swamp creatures. Politicians don't have power, dude. It's just the banks.
Yeah.
We fucked up.
Or it's the evil within the hearts of men. We'll find out. We'll find out what happens. Or we'll just get automated. Dude, I watched WALL-E recently. I think we're just...
WALL-E?
Yeah.
I fucking love
WALL-E. That movie's so fucking WALL-E's good.
WALL-E's so good.
That movie's so fucking awesome, man. But I think that's a... I think if they can mollify us quick enough with like step up the diversion levels, they'll be all right. Like I'm telling you, if we can step up like holographic auto blow technology, things will settle down big time.
Everyone getting head from
virtual head. If they step up virtual head fast, it's gonna be
tough when you find out who's getting head from, like, if you can just decide who's giving you head.
Exactly.
That's gonna bother me.
Mm-hmm.
I might make you do it.
Do you think I would do it?
We've talked about this in the metaverse. Just be like, I'm going to fuck your dad. I might set it, yeah. If you can like deepfake somebody's face onto it.
I was talking about this
but
recently.
But you know it's not your dad giving you head, so it's not weird. But you could do it.
You could if you wanted to, yeah. You do whatever you want. Dude, I've talked about this recently. Everyone laughs at the metaverse. Everyone's going to be hooked on it in like 5 years.
Yeah.
People laugh to Facebook like, what is this?
Yeah, I want to share pictures. Yeah, right.
They're going to come out with a different version of it that's going to be fucked up at how good it is, and everyone's going to be addicted. Everyone's like, yeah, right. And it's like, dude, you're addicted to this little cell phone.
Yeah.
Wait till you project a holographic reality you can inhabit when you go home. You're fried. It's over. It's over for the week. You'll be ensnared in technology. But I don't know. We shall see.
Tybalt, don't show the world your dirty ass.
Show the
Watch
world.
Watch the end there. I think he might have some shit on the back.
Yeah, I saw a dried something over there.
Tybalt's been dropping vicious diarrhea. He's been sick.
I saw something clumped on the end.
Tybalt's not afraid to go outside and munch a bird and come inside and be sick for a fucking month, dude. Get out of here.
But yeah, man. What else is up?
We covered Pearl Harbor, Lafayette, Trump's the man, Hunter Biden's guilty, standard.
Dude, the pedo Peter shit's too fucking funny.
I don't know enough. I don't know about it.
We were watching videos on the way. We tried to get red-pilled on the way up, but we're watching videos.
You gotta try to get red-pilled.
It's all foreigners, dude. It's all foreigners being like, and what is this pedo Peter? And dude, it's so fucking funny.
Oh, it's the Russians.
No, this is a Frenchman. This is a Frenchman.
I think the Russians are trying to tear us apart.
Probably, yeah.
They stole the election when Trump won.
Yeah, they did.
I like it. That's my favorite, too, is like how Trump, they're like, the right's just trying to get rid of democracy. It's like, when you guys lost, you literally said the president was a spy for Russia. What the fuck are you talking about?
I know. Yeah, man. I mean, dude, it's so far removed from like the ins and outs of running a country. It's people just have projected themselves onto political parties and they're like, we need to win.
Yeah.
No, there's no basis, in my opinion, there's no basis on like anything. Like,
probably need the forward party.
That's what I'm saying.
Shout
dude.
Out Andrew Yang, dude.
Dude, it's coming.
By the way, Yang, man, he hooked it up.
Man, he's a beast.
He hooked up that interview we did. They edited the fuck out of that.
Really?
Definitely. That thing was way longer than it was that they put out. That most of it was like just me dead. Andrew Yang sitting there like, what the fuck is going on? I'm just having a tough time, Andrew. I looked at the comments and everybody fucking hates me, Andrew.
I'm just tired these days.
I'm just fucking exhausted.
It sucks that this art form doesn't allow for like clever crushes on haters. You can't crush haters on a podcast.
Haters,
you just get annihilated.
Although there was some McGoobies dorks.
Really?
This past weekend.
What's the problem?
There was this dude. His bros were fans. They showed up. Him and his bros all wore like Hawaiian shirts.
Swag.
It was fun. They're just guys going out having fun.
Yeah.
I come out of the bathroom. This one dude, ponytail, pale, beard, skinny.
Really?
Hawaiian shirt. He's like, Patagonia. I was like, yeah. He's like, those are expensive shirts. Those are nice, dude. It's cool. You're wearing a Patagonia. And I was like, all right. You trying to like neg me? What are you doing? He was like, Patagonia. He was hammered.
Was this before or after the show?
It was after the show.
Yeah.
And I was like, all right, do you want to talk about shirts? You're wearing a fucking Hawaiian shirt. You have a ponytail. You look like a fucking dumbass. And I walked away. And I was like, what was that? So later on, I'm at the bar. I'm at the bar and I sit next to the guy. because I didn't think it was anything.
You were locked on at that point.
No. I didn't think it was anything aggressive. Yeah, I thought it was right, cool. No, I swear to God. I was talking to Andrew. There was one seat at the bar. It just happened to be next to this guy. So while I'm talking to Andrew, yeah. I hear him go, Pedagon. He's like trying to say it again.
Oh.
And I was just still in a conversation. I was like, I ignored it. I pretended I didn't hear it. He tried like three different times to say Patagonia.
Yeah.
And finally I turned around and I was like, what, dude? What?
Yeah.
And he was like, just wearing Patagonia shirt. It's fucking pretty dumb. And I was just like, dude, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you doing that? And he was like, I don't know. He was like, didn't you get like fired from SNL? And I was just like, dude, what are you doing?
This dude kind of rules.
I was like, why are you trying to? I was like, that's how I started fucking with him because I could tell he was a little drunk and I wasn't there yet. And I was like, why are you being rude to me? Don't you think it's strange to just be rude to me for no reason? He was like, I don't care who you are. And I was like, I didn't say you did. Why are you being rude right now? And then everybody started kind of making fun of him. And he was like, okay, everybody just gang up on me then. It was. He might have been one of the biggest tools of all time.
That's intensely sad.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I would venture the guy wasn't feeling too good about himself.
Yeah.
Then he saw your Patagonia as like a beacon of like material success and was like, fuck that guy.
I don't understand what it was.
That's what happens. If you don't feel good about yourself, then you just look for someone who's doing well. And then you just go, you know what? That guy might be doing well and all, but he's a fucking bitch.
No,
I'm right.
He saw the show. He was at the show.
Really?
Yeah. So he saw. That's why he was going after me. He was like, you think everybody likes you?
Well, that
like,
too.
Stuff like that. And it was like, all right, you fucking weirdo.
I do admire just the capacity of the human mind to be like, watch a whole bunch of people being like, this is funny and enjoying it and being like, I'm pretty sure I'm better than this guy.
Yeah.
And then just looking and being like, nice fleece, you bitch.
Yeah.
It is tight.
I've been there.
Your brain does protect yourself against like negative self-appraisals.
One guy had a rough time.
Really?
My girlfriend was at the bar and this girl was like, I like your dress. And he was like, I think it's ugly.
Oh.
And then he found out she was my girlfriend. And he was like, I'm so sorry. So she came back to the green room and told me.
Really?
So I went out and I was like,
what the fuck, dude?
Who the fuck said that? And of course, it's just nice boy. And I was a little hard on him. I was like, you're fucking ugly as shit. I was on a warpath. It was before the show. I was furious. I was in a bad mood.
True. Yeah, that'll happen.
And I had conflicting reports. My girlfriend told me he said something much more demeaning.
Really?
I might believe her. I'm not certain.
I do
believe all women.
True.
Especially
science
when it's my girlfriend
real.
Versus
science
a drunk fan.
Science is real.
Science is real. Free Ukraine.
Immigrants are hot. What's the rest of the science say? Immigrants
real.
Are hot.
Water is life.
Muslim women are fantastic at
Muslim
driving.
Muslim women are sick as fuck at driving.
What does that sign say again?
Science is real.
Muslims.
Water
are,
is life.
Water's life. Muslim women are
no
fantastic
people
at
are
driving.
Illegal.
Yep.
Something about Islam's the shit.
Islam is.
Sharia.
Women's rights are human
rights.
That's actually very true. No, I don't know if you know that, but women are humans and their rights are human rights.
Yes. So.
Take that up with the sign.
Yeah, doy.
Love is love and kindness is everything.
Love is love.
So even like and Nazis loving, man. What about like Nazis loving Nazis? Love is love.
Love is love. Love is love.
Technically that love is love. But kindness hate has no home here.
What if you love the Holocaust? Love is love, dude.
Love is love, dude.
And hate does not have any home.
Hate doesn't have a home here.
Not at all.
Hate doesn't live here.
So if you love the Holocaust, you wouldn't have a home. But
I put this sign up in our front yard. Me and my wife get along. Obviously, my wife's not a fucking psycho bitch. That's why the sign's out front.
Oh.
Yeah. I saw a sign.
Dude, you can't allow your that's the final frontier.
When your
like,
wife starts
no.
fucking putting out dumb
no,
signs.
No signs. No political signage. Dude, it's fucking lamb's blood now. I told you, there's one, in my neighborhood's all love is real, whatever. And then there's this one family that's like, we say Christmas, or we say Merry Christmas,
fuck yeah.
We support the troops, we love cops. If any of that offends you, get the fuck away from my house. Or it says something like, get away from my house. And they always have just like St. Paddy's Day decorations up all year round.
Those are drunks.
Yeah, those guys are
fucked up. I get it. You get a couple drinks, you're like, dude, I fucking love the boys in blue.
It's nice, too, to red pill yourself just by alcoholism. Just like you're at a bar, you're at an Irish pub so much that one TV channel's on, you're like, what are they doing?
You can drink your way. Yeah. You can drink your way into being a full on fucking troop, dude. I've seen it. I've been there. I've drank my way into troophood. I've drank my way into be like, you know what? I'll say it. Donald Trump is the best.
it is funny though,
dude. You know that story about, remember when they had those cowboys, the border patrol guys that were chasing Haitian dudes on horses and allegedly whipping them?
I heard about that. Yeah.
It wasn't true.
You told me that a long time ago.
It wasn't true.
So none of, you said you suspected heavily it wasn't true.
Obviously, we don't have dudes on the border with bull whips hitting black dudes, dude. Obviously. It's so ridiculous. But it's, and then it's like you keep looking at it, and then it's like, oh yeah, remember that Covington thing? That was fake.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Remember every single one of these fucking injustice moments that we've had? Yeah.
Wait, so what was the true story? Fake? What was the true story behind the Marlboro men on the border?
The Marlboro men were fucking pissed. The Haitians were crossing the river and scrambling.
Utah!
They were going in different directions. And so the Marlboro men had their fucking horse whip. So the pictures.
Why would they be carrying whips at the border?
No, they're to ride their horse. Oh, wow. It's not like a full whip. It's the reins.
Polo. It was like a horse race whip. No. They didn't have an Indiana Jones.
I think they used their reins. I could be wrong.
Maybe. Right? Maybe the border patrol was running away from a large rolling boulder, and then they saw Haitians, and they were like, trying.
We also got scooped the Haitians.
They're trying to escape a rolling boulder.
But yeah, the photographer came out. The photographer came out that took the pictures and was like, nobody whipped anybody.
Yeah.
And CNN was like, nuh-uh. People were definitely whipping them. And then Biden came out. That he was like, we're gonna fucking destroy the men who did this.
Oh my god.
Kamala Harris came out. It was like, this is inexcusable.
What?
It's like, make sure it happened before you say it's inexcusable.
It doesn't matter. Truly does. It is funny to think about how people are just bopping around.
Do we stop with those cages down there?
Because
all of a sudden, no one cares.
You know what? It's done. That would, dude, when I was in social work school.
What the hell's going on?
People show pictures like they're keeping kids in cages. It's like, how about you leave and go get them? They're children in cages.
Like, well, or you can stay here and study.
Yeah. It's like, dude.
You can study, which is very important to the kids in the cages.
Yeah.
They're going to want you guys to have good degrees.
Yeah, you can pretend to read Foku or whatever the guy's Focal or whatever his name is. Or you can go open those cages, dude.
You got to go down there and
it's
open
like,
the cages.
It's like, dude, it's a $200 flight. You can go down there right now. There's nothing stopping
AOC
you.
AOC went down and cried in front of the cages.
Did she cry in front of the cages?
For a photo op. She went down and cried in front of the cages. For real. You ever see those? She's like.
Did she really?
Yeah, they took pictures of it. She literally went down and boohooed. She fucking boohooed. As if she's not a politician that could probably make some difference.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm sure she is trying.
Trying to get stop
as
the cages.
As gay as she is, she's at least trying to do her
stop
thing.
Stop the cages. Yeah, at least she went to the cages.
So at least she did go down a cage
and
cry.
I was with nothing but women who I'm pretty sure most of their parents were very wealthy who are bemoaning these cages. And I was like, yo, you could be there right now.
Did you like... Obama built the cages.
I didn't know yet.
He showed up, dude.
I didn't know yet.
Just so you know, Obama built those cages.
I was red-pilled the whole time. I was too red-pilled in social work school.
Goodbye, Tybalt.
It does not go well. I want to go back in. I want to re-enlist in social work school and
go back.
Just
be a menace.
Dude, I spend so much
time.
Just
be Walter, dude.
Who's
going to
Walter
Philpeck?
I might go back there. Yeah.
Just be like, well, that's not what I'm here to do. I'm here to kill or be killed. So that's what I've done.
Yeah, I want to go back. I think about it a lot. I'm like, dude, I'd love to go back now. I know so much more. I would fucking win so many more.
I think
more
about going to school again right now,
dude,
too.
Dude, it's so fun. Going to college is so fucking fun.
It'd probably
fun.
Make me mad and I'd cry in class.
I almost cried one time. A bunch of women ganged up on me and were yelling at me, and I'm like,
you guys don't
I almost
understand.
Cried the one time I started getting real. I was like,
I'd cry.
I don't know why you guys are fucking, everything I say, you guys are just fucking assholes. And they were just like, whoa. They were so mean, dude. They were so fucking mean. My question was, look, they're talking trans stuff. I'm like, that's cool and all, or genderqueer. And I was like, that's all fine. Do whatever you want. But if gender is just a social construct, why are you guys so fucking obsessed with being called a certain thing? And they were like, "Van." I was like, "All right, that's all. It's just a question. It's all a question."
Yeah,
I claim to have the answers. If it's a justice, you're
just asking questions.
Why are you so obsessed?
You're just trying to investigate the investigators.
I was like, "Why is it so important that I get yours right if it's just some weird
How
construct?
Did they know who did 9/11 so quickly the way they did Lee Harvey Oswald?"
Whenever there was a question, they stumped them. They would just go, "Fuck!" They would spaz. They would just get angry. It was so funny. I couldn't stop doing it. I was like, "Dude, just show up, chill. You're almost done." And I would sit there and I would go,
"Yeah, I have a question,
dude." They did a study the one time.
Mama said,
"They did a study the one time where they talked about how ethnic pride. If you can increase ethnic pride, it like helps people's mental health. So if you get people like pumped on their ethnicity." It helped, and it was just a study of black people, and I was like, "That's kind of weird." So like, does this translate to white people? If I got like really pumped on being white, and they're like, "Don't you dare, dude!" They spaz. And I was like, "That's just a fucking good question." I'm like, "Should I be pumped on my ethnicity? Like, will that help me?" And they were like, "That's not what this is about." The lady,
it's exactly the, what it's
dude,
about.
The teacher went, "Let me guess, you're Irish, right?" And I was like, "Whoa!" I was like, "Yeah,
whoa.
What's up with that?" And she's like, "That's an ethnicity." I was like, "So black's not an ethnicity?" She was like. Well, and it was just kind of like, all right, I'm just saying that's a fucking weird study. I hope everyone feels good about themselves, but I'm like, I don't know if you want to be a, I don't know if that one has to make the front lines of the medical health stuff of being like, here's what you got to do. Take two trips down an Irish weekend and your anxiety will disappear.
By the way, that's the fucking mecca of anxiety. Waking up after Irish weekend from Philadelphia, just like, ah.
It's also weird. Like, what would the therapy behind that be? Of just being like, "Listen, man, you're black as hell." Oh, Dibble, oh, there's poop. Dibble, shit the rug. Yo, pan that and get that shit.
Dibble.
Pan that and get that shit.
Dibble, don't wipe your ass on the carpet.
Dibble, dude, what the fuck, dude? Dibble, dude.
Guard dog, if you miss Dibble wiping his ass, we've got problems.
He might do a little
Holy
victory
shit,
lap. Damn, dude.
This cat is a fucking disgusting cat.
Just walks
dude.
Away like it's nothing. Dude.
Oh, he's going. Dude, get him.
There he goes.
Oh. Tibble, clean up your fucking act, dude.
Unacceptable. Oh my god.
Shit on the floor. What? Dude, my parents hate this fucking cat.
Dude, I'm surprised they haven't gotten rid of it.
This is all he does.
That's crazy they keep it.
Bro, he's a wild animal.
Yeah, well, I see.
He literally, he's not close to domesticated.
I just shit on
the rug. He tears up everything in this house.
What the fuck?
And then he goes out, they let him outside at night, and he just eats animals.
My dad would kill this cat. My dad would take this to the vet and get it put down today.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
He
will.
Phil, instantly.
Phil will see this when he comes back.
Oh,
from
dude,
Pittsburgh, and I'll just go,
God damn it.
Fucking cat.
Dude, my dad would put this cat. Is he hunting his turds now?
He's taking a look at the turds.
He's checking them out.
I understand. Nah, you don't have to film the poor boy.
This is Nat Geo.
This is a. Yeah.
Yeah, that's.
I'm not happy with that performance.
I mean, that's pretty much. Yeah.
Tybalt, I've never seen a cat this bad.
That's like, just that's me reading my tweets.
Just shitting.
Just looking at him. Just looking at him. Be like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you were getting a little manic. I was like kind of worried.
No, I was just having fun.
Yeah, all right. That's what I tell you. I was like, you're wild on Twitter. And you were like, I'm having fun. I was like, all right, good,
I was having a
good,
blast
good,
the other
good.
Day. Just sitting there bored as hell.
Yeah.
But yeah, that seems to be the menu for people. It's just there's this like swirl of nonsense information. You have to just build a life out of it. We're like birds just picking up balls of yarn and like stuffing them into a nest and being like, this is my fucking personality or whatever. Fucking, this is what I'm pumped about Hunter Biden right now. And, you know, this is exciting.
Yeah.
That he smoked crack.
He did smoke some
apparently,
crack.
Apparently, and allegedly looked up 12-year-old porn, which is like, dude.
Maybe he was just investigating the investigator. He was like, I want to make sure Pornhub doesn't have this up there. I'm going to flag it.
True. True.
Maybe he was hunting.
Maybe he was looking for he had a tape. He was looking for damning evidence. Yes. Like our friend of the podcast.
Yes.
Who went out and searched who had the fucking pedo tapes.
True.
Buried in New Mexico.
Yeah, yeah. It was a treasure. Where were we at?
52. I knew it.
52.
But yeah, no, I think I've been pretty numb to my emotional experience and I've been bored just writing on Twitter, having a good time, and then everything I write, I just go.
That was fun. I just had my guard up for manic episodes after what's been going on.
True.
So I was genuinely like, damn, what would happen if one of my, because a dude I know is having a manic episode. And it's it sucks because he was totally normal.
Yeah. No, I have my manic episodes. I have like a governor on them. They're pretty nice. I kind of enjoy them. I've been battle tested, and it's like,
I've received some business plans.
Yeah, exactly. That's
about the extent.
That's the extent of it.
Like, here's what we got to do.
Yeah.
I figured it out.
Yeah, all I do is come up with like a really cool idea that I abandon in like 3 days.
Yeah.
That's the high end.
I don't even think I don't think that's crazy at all.
No, it's just.
You're just a wild dude.
I'm telling you, I get a little, you're every now and again, I get a burst of energy.
Yeah.
And I'm like, sweet. And like 3 months later, I go, shit, I should have said I was going to fucking do this. Now I have this fucking problem I have to deal with. Why did I do that? I'm such an idiot. But yeah, no, I don't think I could ever fully detach from reality completely. Yeah.
We'll see.
Or if I did, I think I'd be able to like keep it all in.
Yeah. I hope I die before I lose my mind.
Yeah. That'd be preferable.
Guys, when you've had a long day and you want to unwind like a grown-up, grab your favorite Lucy gum or nicotine pouch. I like it. I use nicotine pouches.
Yep.
And it makes you not want to dip or smoke. For me, it's good because when I'm out in public, people don't like seeing you dip. They go, what the fuck is wrong with you? That's disgusting.
Yep.
And then somebody spills your spitter and everyone's mad at you.
Yep.
Because somebody else kicked it. If you've been looking for an alternative to smoking, why not switch to a nicotine product that you can feel good about? The government is banning vapes. Whoa.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Biden's son can smoke crack, but I can't fucking vape, dude.
Biden's son can smoke crack. And Biden can go on the Senate floor and issue laws saying if you smoke crack, you go to jail for 10 years. Yeah. No questions asked. 5 years minimum. Meanwhile, his son. All of a sudden, the Washington Post is like, hey, maybe crack's okay.
Oh, dude.
The government's banning vapes and reducing the amount of nicotine in cigarettes. There's never been a better time to give Lucy a try. If you enjoy using nicotine, you need to check out Lucy's products at lucy.co. I like that Lucy's going with the gun sales technique where it's like, hey, government's trying to take your guns.
I know, it's kind of nice.
Yeah. That's lucy.co. Use promo code DRENCH to check out. If you're a listener from Canada, you can now get Lucy at ca.lucy.co. Warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical. Thank you.
Awesome.
We did it. Tybalt.
We did.
God damn it, dude.
Just staring at his turd, dude.
He's falling asleep looking at his own shit.
That's it. He's looking back at the last week of his life just going, what the fuck?
What have I been up to?
What the fuck?
I feel bad. Well, you know what it is, though? That's not a full crap. This is what happens. He's got a damaged ass, and he's had a damaged ass since he was a kitten. So he'll take a full shit, and then those little turds will still be stuck.
Ah.
And sometimes you'll see him run. He tries to run to get
him
off. So he's had a damaged asshole. It probably happened when whatever munched his tail.
He got his asshole bitten.
He got his asshole damaged and his tail's damaged. So he always has a tiny turd that falls out.
Did he get his asshole mauled by like a coyote or something? That thing,
he did get mauled once. He's been through some battles.
Damn,
he's an outdoor fucking cat.
Jesus Christ.
But when he dumps, it's a log, dude. He craps. You see the size of that thing. He's a fucking bowling ball.
True.
He's a thick boy.
Yeah, the way he's laying looks comfortable as fuck, though.
He is comfortable looking.
But
next time I get a cat, I'm going to get a Maine Coon.
The one that looks like a leopard, kind of?
No, that's a Savannah cat.
Really?
Maine Coons have big, fat paws.
Oh.
Long hair. I'll show you a nice Maine Coon. I might get a Hemingway cat, too.
That'll be nice.
They have thumbs.
What?
Yeah.
Opposable?
Yeah, they got thumbs.
What the fuck?
Look at these guys. That's a good Maine Coon.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. Dude, yeah, that would be nasty.
Look at that thing.
That'd be
big
cool.
Big as shit.
Fuck, dude. Yeah, you need that.
I need that guy, but I can't live in a city if I have one of these guys.
Why? Walk it. Dude, if you started walking a Maine Coon, dude, you would be...
I would be kind of
unstoppable. Your legend would grow.
Look at that thing.
Fuck, dude. You got to get that. Are you supposed to have them outside?
I would imagine these are some outdoor guys.
You think so?
They're going to want to be outside. Yeah,
let
dude,
them
look
bro,
at that thing.
Bro.
That thing's built to be, that's a lion.
Yeah, true.
Take it for
a long walk. Yeah, you don't even want to walk it either.
I actually have never kept a cat inside.
Let it out.
Dude, you gotta go eat rats.
I like them being outside killing stuff. And if they die out in nature, good.
Exactly.
It's better than taking them to a vet and putting them down.
100%.
I'd rather them get mauled by a fucking dog.
Couldn't agree more.
Yeah.
Or just get, in New York, like run over.
Cats are killers.
Yeah.
They should be killed eventually.
For sure.
That's how it goes.
Dude, just let a Maine Coon run around New York City and have it like pinned so you know exactly where it is.
That would be a problem in New York.
Dude, GoPro a Maine Coon. That would be sick. Watching it eat, let it out at like midnight. It'll eat rats 100%.
It would destroy rats.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty cool, guys. Why don't you guys get off your phones, or are you looking at Maine Coons? Breaks my heart to see him like this, dude. No, makes me sad, dude.
Yeah, Tybalt. He's done. Tybalt, what have you done? We should take him out behind the woodshed between apps.
Hit him with a shovel.
Just put him down, dude.
I can't wait to go upstairs and tell my mom.
He pooped.
She fucking hates Tybalt. She's been trying to kill this cat.
Oh, my dude, this thing.
Phil keeps him alive because Phil comes home, has a couple beers on the recliner.
Mess with him?
Tybalt's his buddy.
Yeah, man, this thing would be dead. This thing would be dead in the house.
Yeah, Phil has a soft spot for cats.
My dad has it for dogs. He does the same thing. Like, get this goddamn thing out of here.
Obviously, you can never kill a dog. That'd be bad.
It would be fucked up.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Cats are much easier to kill.
For sure. But a dog, you can take
him. A dog's your friend.
It is your buddy.
This thing, Tybalt doesn't give a fuck about anything.
Not at all. Well, dudes, let's go to the Patreon.
That's a good episode, talking cats.
True.
Catch us over at the Patreon. It's going to be a fun one, dude.
Oh, my God.
I got plenty stored up for the Patreon. Me too. I saved it. I got a lot of good stories.
Me too. I always save all my good
stuff. Wait till you hear this juicy info I have about Andrew Yang.
Really?
Oh, yeah.